In today's Medico Apps Masterclass, we will learn about the muscles of tongue. Muscles of tongue are divided into extrinsic group of muscles and intrinsic group of muscles. Extrinsic group of muscles have an attachment to a bone outside the tongue, whereas intrinsic group of muscles interestingly have their origin as well as insertion within the tongue. The extrinsic group of muscles help to move the tongue, whereas the intrinsic group of muscles change the shape and the size of the tongue, so they have a role in the speech, eating and swallowing. Also, intrinsic group of muscles are named in the direction in which they travel. So we have got four pairs of intrinsic muscles: the superior longitudinal, the inferior longitudinal, the vertical and the transverse. They are named in the direction in which they travel. The extrinsic group of muscles, again we have got four groups of extrinsic muscle: the genioglossus, the hyoglossus, the styloglossus and the palatoglossus. So these are the four extrinsic group of muscles. Before we move and see in detail about their origin, insertion and the action, let's look at the nerve supply of these muscles. Now, all the intrinsic as well as extrinsic muscles of tongue are innervated by the 12th cranial nerve, that is the hypoglossal nerve, and all of them are developed from the occipital myotomes. The only exception is the palatoglossus muscle. The palatoglossus muscle is derived out of the 6th pharyngeal arch, and hence it is innervated by the motor branch of vagus nerve via pharyngeal plexus. So one of the most important points you have to remember is all the muscles of tongue is innervated by the 12th cranial nerve, the only exception being palatoglossus, which is a derivative of 6th pharyngeal arch, and hence it is supplied by the motor innervation of vagus nerve via pharyngeal plexus. Let's start and look at the intrinsic muscles of the tongue. This is a cross section of the tongue which will show all the intrinsic muscles of the tongue. Let's look at each of the intrinsic muscles of tongue one by one. The first set is the superior longitudinal muscle. So superior longitudinal muscle, as you can see in the diagram, it is marked. Now you have to understand, the longitudinal muscles run across the length of the tongue. So once it contracts, it will shorten the tongue. The first set is superior longitudinal. So superior longitudinal makes the tongue shorter, as well as because it is on the superior side of the tongue, the moment it will contract, it would make the dorsum of the tongue concave as shown in the diagram. The next is the inferior longitudinal muscle. So this is in the cross section where you can see the inferior longitudinal muscles. As already said, because it is a longitudinal muscle, if it contracts, it will make the tongue into a shorter. Also, because it is on the inferior side, it will make the dorsum convex. So superior longitudinal, inferior longitudinal, both the muscles will shorten the tongue. However, superior longitudinal, because it is on top, it will make the dorsum concave, whereas inferior longitudinal, because it is below, it will make the dorsum into a convex structure. Next set we have is the vertical intrinsic muscles. Vertical intrinsic muscles, this is where you can see in the cross section. Now, since it is running vertical, the moment it contracts, it will make the tongue into a broad and flattened. So vertical muscles, the moment it will contract, it will reduce the length, it will reduce the height of the tongue, and so the tongue will become flattened and broad. Next, we have the transverse muscle. So the transverse intrinsic muscle, here you can see in the cross section the transverse muscle. Once it contracts, the transverse muscle will make the tongue into a narrow and elongated structure. So vertical and transverse will have opposite function. Vertical muscles will make the tongue into a broad and flattened structure, whereas transverse muscles will make the tongue into a narrow and elongated structure. Let's look at the extrinsic muscles of the tongue. So the first extrinsic muscle of the tongue is the genioglossus, As seen in the diagram, it starts from the mental symphysis and gets attached to the dorsum of the tongue. So this is a fan-shaped muscle, and it has got superior, middle and inferior fiber. The superior fiber will draw the tip of the tongue back and down. The middle fiber will depress the tongue, whereas the inferior fiber will protrude the tongue. Now, because of this inferior fibers of the genioglossus, this typically contracts in an unconscious patient. And so, in an unconscious patient, the tongue is protruded out and is prevented from falling back and blocking the airway. So, this is the reason why genioglossus, especially because of its inferior fibers, is called as the safety muscle of the tongue. Why it is called as the safety muscle of the tongue? Because in an unconscious patient, the contraction of genioglossus makes the tongue protruding outside and not letting it fall back and block the airway. Thereby, it is calling as the safety muscle of the tongue. The next pair of the muscle is hyoglossus. Hyoglossus, as the name suggests, will start from the hyoid bone and will go up to the side of the tongue. Now, just imagine, because hyoid is behind the tongue and below the tongue, the action on contraction will be depression of the tongue and it will retract the tongue. So hyoglossus, the action is it will depress and retract the tongue. Next we have is the styloglossus. It will start from the styloid process to the side of the tongue. Now again, because hyoid was down and behind, this is up and behind the tongue. The action would be it will elevate the tongue and retract the tongue. So because both of them are behind the tongue, both of them will retract, but because styloglossus is on superior part, it will elevate the tongue, whereas hyoglossus is inferiorly situated, so it will depress the tongue. Hope you are clear with the muscle actions of these two. Last we have is the platyglossus. Platyglossus is from palatine aponeurosis and it gets attached broadly across the tongue. Now the main action is, because again it is situated on the superior part, superior to the tongue, it will elevate the posterior aspect of the tongue. So these are the four extrinsic muscles of the tongue. Most important MCQ would be genioglossus is called as the safety muscle of the tongue. Also, the action of various different muscles is oftenly asked. The attachments are not generally asked, but the action, like say styloglossus elevates and retracts the tongue. I mean, the actions is very frequently asked. Let's look at the most important points on this topic, which are asked across various entrance examinations. Muscles of tongue are developing from occipital myotomes. The only exception is palatoglossal muscle. Palatoglossal muscle develops from the sixth arch of the mesoderm. Hereby, all the muscles of tongue are supplied by the 12th cranial nerve, that is the hypoglossal nerve. The exception being palatoglossal muscle, which is supplied by the vagus nerve, the motor component of the vagus nerve, via pharyngeal plexus. Also, genioglossus is called as the safety muscle of the tongue. Also, questions are asked on the injury of hypoglossal nerve. Injury to the hypoglossal nerve leads to the paralysis of the muscle on the affected side. So, tongue is pulled to the opposite side and protruded on the paralytic side. In diagram, you can see that the tongue is deviated towards the right side. So, in this case, the injury of the left hypoglossal nerve would be there. Before we finish, the brain teaser question for today would be, which muscle is called as the safety muscle of tongue and why? If you know the answer, leave in the comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and once you subscribe, hit the bell icon so that you can get any notification whenever we upload a new video lecture. Check out this next MedicoApps masterclass and hope you will find it beneficial.